Okay, now going to the next question, that is sum number 6. So we are continuing with sum number 6 now. So the question states this way, there are two forces. There's a point over here which is point O, and there are two forces which are going to be coming like this. One going upwards with F is equals to 10 Newton, and other going downwards with F is equals to 10 Newton. This point over here is point O, this point over here is point B. And it's given that these are 50 centimeters apart. You need to find out the first one, calculate the moment of two forces about the point A, about the point B, and about the point O, which is situated in the middle. That means this over here is 25 and this over here is 25. Okay, so you can see over here that we'll be taking up one by one. The first one, you know, the forces is 10, 10 only. So when we take this point A over here, so at point A, see, at point A, what is going to happen is there are two forces. One is a force of F1 over here, another one is a force of F2, both acting at this particular point. Now, so moment is equals to moment of F1 plus moment of F2. Okay, so you see over here that the moment of F1 is nothing but F1 into the distance of A, so D, plus F2 into D. Now F1 over here is 10, but the D is 0 because A and the line of action of force is the same point. Therefore, this will be 0 over here. Do you understand this? This one, A point, if I am applying a force at the pivoted point, if I apply the force at the pivoted point, will there be any movement? No, there won't be any movement over here. So it will be 0 plus this one, the next one is 10 into 50, because this distance is 50, so this distance, so point of application force will be like this. So into 50 centimeters, which is nothing, 50 into 100. So this cancels over here, it will be 5 Newton meter, and the direction of the force will be clockwise. So it will be clockwise. That's the first answer. Second one is at point B. It will be similar thing. At point B, the same thing is going to happen. The moment will be equal to 10 into 0 because of this particular point. This point is the same as F2. So it will be, or we can say this one. The first one is 10 into 50 upon, because it is F1, so it is upon 100, plus 10 into 0. That again, it will become as 5 Newton meter. But here now, it is going to be this way. Because, sorry, it is going to be applied here. So it is going to be again the same way, clockwise. So it will be clockwise. Because it is again point B. So point B, and push karenge, so it is going to go like this. So accordingly, it is going to be in the clockwise direction. And finally, they want it at from O. So at point O, we see the moment will be equal to F1 is 10, and this is 25 upon 100 plus 10 into 25 upon 100. So this becomes 2.5 plus 2.5 is equals to 5 Newton meter clockwise. Got it? So you can see from all the three points, if you are going to take the moment, it will be the same 5 Newton meter clockwise, 5 Newton meter clockwise, and 5 Newton meter clockwise from point A, B, or O. Okay. The next thing is, we go through the next question, that is question number 7. Now, in question number 7, they are given you a question that a steering wheel of diameter 0.5 meter rotates in an anti-clockwise by applying two forces, each of magnitude 5 Newton. So it is this way, that this particular steering wheel is going to move anti-clockwise by this particular moment. So if for that, I need to apply a force here and apply a force like this. So here it is going to be this way and here it is going to be this way. Two forces of, now diameter is given as 0.5 meters. So this is 0.5 meters is the diameter. This is 5 Newton and this is also 5 Newton over here. Now we need to find out that you have to draw the figure. So this is the figure exactly what we want, that a steering wheel with the diameter equal to 0.5 meters application of force, this is over here, this application of force is of 5 Newton, and another application of force over here is of 5 Newton. So they both form a couple. Now because they are forming the couple, so we'll have the same thing over here. Moment of couple is equals to F into D is 5 into 0.5 is equal to 2.5 Newton meter, and they're already given that is going to be given you anti-clockwise. So anti-clockwise will be the answer to this. Now, so calculate the moment of force is nothing but 2.5 Newton meter. Easy question. Now we are coming to the important parts now, which are about the uniform meter rule. So whenever the question of uniform meter rule comes, it's going to be equal difficult, because these are the ones, are the kind of questions which are going to be asked in the board. So we have to be very attentive now, be attentive and see to this thing properly. Now, a uniform meter rule is pivoted at its midpoint. So, the first thing, now as soon as you see, you read the thing, uniform meter rule, you need to make a figure. So, the figure will be like this, that this is your meter rule. So, 0, 50, 100. That's a meter rule. The next thing is that they are given that it is pivoted at the midpoint. So, at the midpoint, there is this particular pivoted point over here. The next thing is, a weight of 50 GF is suspended at one end of it. Where should the weight of 100 GF be suspended to keep the horizontal rule? So, first, we'll see that we'll be putting one of the weight of 50 GF at one end. So, we want to put it at over here, one end of 50 GF. Okay. Now, so obviously the other one will be over somewhere here. Yahan pe 100 GF ka mujhe lagana hai. So, this will be at X position. So the first thing is, as per principle of moment, so by principle of equilibrium, not moment, equilibrium. Now, this triangle over here, uske niche likh do yahan pe equal to, ye wale forces are going to be anti-clockwise. So sum of, I'll put the short form, anti-clockwise moment is equal to sum of clockwise moment. So what are forces over here? This is nothing but F into D. It is 50 into 50. That is the force. This is the force and this is the distance. Over here, it is the same thing. Force into the distance over here. Now distance over here is not X. The distance over here is X minus 20, because we have to take the distance between these two points. Here also we can take it as 50 minus 0, or and here we can write it as X minus 50. So that we are finding out the exact distance over here and not talking about the points which are written over here. If I take the points over here, then I can get, see here when I take the X, I'll get the answer as yo, meter rule mein kaun se point pe hai. If I don't take it that way, I can get the distance from the center. I'll give you when the answer is done. So it is like 2500 is equals to 100x minus 5000. So that gives you 2500 plus 5000 is equals to 100x. So x is equals to 7500 upon 100 is equals to 75 centimeter mark. You can consider that this is the answer over here. But if at all you would have suggested in this way, that this thing is over here and this is over here, then automatically the answer will be different. So we can say that if I take the value of x over here like this, then I'm going to get that particular mark. Okay, ke wo kaun se mark pe wo force hai. If I don't take it this way and I consider the x jo hai, wo distance hai yahan ka, then what will happen is that I'm going to take it as x. So it will be 100 into x. So it will be 100x is equals to over here 2500. Hence, what will happen? X will be equal to 25. So this is 25 centimeters on other side of the 50 GF weight. So 50 GF jahan pe bhi hai, uska other side mein, from the center, 25 centimeters, sorry, from center. Okay? From the pivoted point or center. That is on this side. So either you can write it this way or yeah, but main thing is that whatever you do, you have to pinpoint that what is the value of x you have taken. If you are showing over here as x, then 75 is the right answer. If you are showing this distance as x, then 25 centimeters from the center is the right answer. You can take both the ways. Meter will diya rahega. Ideally take this one. Agar SA distance diya rahega, then you can take it from the center. Both the answers are correct. In the textbook, they are given at a distance of 25 centimeters on the other end. So same thing. Exactly the same thing. Okay. Let's see the next question. And that is question number 9. Okay. I'll just keep it like this so that agar kisi ko bhi beech mein pause karke copy down karna hai to kar sake. Okay. Right. Chal, we go to the next question. Question number 9. A uniform meter rule balances horizontally on a knife edge placed at 58 centimeter mark. So again, the same thing. You are going to draw a meter rule. This meter rule, what you draw over here, will be 0, 50, 100. And at 58, you are having this particular pivoted point. The next is, when a weight of 20 GF is suspended from one end, it is going to be balancing when 28 GF is going to be this end, and you need to find out the weight. So now this over here is the weight of the ruler. The weight of the ruler W is going to act at the 50 centimeter mark. Now once you know that it is going to act at the 50 centimeter mark, so you know that agar maine isko aise rakha, toh it is going to fall this way. So I need to place the weight of 20 GF on this side, because मैंने अगर समझे उसको ये side मिला तो ऐसे भी क्यों इधर गिर रहा है, तो I have to put it on this side. So when I put this on this, so it will be, they are given that 28 centimeters is suspended at one from one end. So one end over here is 20 GF. So 20 GF is over here. Now again the same thing, principle of equilibrium. We have got sum of anti-clockwise movement is equal to sum of clockwise movement. Hence we have over here W into 58 minus 50 is equal to 20 into 100 minus 58. So that gives you as 8W is equal to 42 into 20. So W is equal to 840 upon 8 is 105 GF. So that means that the weight of the ruler over here is 105 GF. Okay, clear? Next one is question number 10. Okay. It's question number 10 now. Okay, the diagram below shows a uniform bar rule. So they already given you a diagram over here, which is not a meter rule, but it is like a meter rule. Only thing is that the markings are such that yahan pe 0 hai, ye bhi 50 hai, ye bhi 50 hai. That means it is going on this side also at 10, 20, 30, and over here also 10, 20, 30. They are given that at 40 marks over here. So 40 mark, that is one weight of, that is 40 GF. And so it's given to you that shows a uniform bar supported at point O. A weight of 40 GF is placed at the distance 40 centimeters to the left of point O. How can you balance the bar with a weight of 80 GF? So you need to place somewhere over here 80 GF so that this gets balanced. Simple. So let's consider this particular point over here. This, of course, now it will be distance over here. So we'll take this distance over here as X. So on this, we see that again, principle of equilibrium, we get sum of anti-clockwise movement is equal to sum of clockwise movement, and we have over here 40 into 40 is equal to 80 into x. 40 is the force, 40 is the distance between these two, 80 is over here, and x is the distance between these two. So this gives you 1600 is equals to 80x, or x is equals to 1600 upon 80, that makes it 20. So this 20 centimeter from O on other side. So you can see on here, this is at 20 centimeter mark. This is the answer over here. Very important to mark over here that the 20 centimeters to the right or 20 on the other side. So you need to mention over there that this particular thing is on the other side of this part. Okay. So that was the 10th question. Now we see the last question of this particular video, that is question number 11 after this. Okay. So it is again a meter rule. So the figure is given to us that it's a meter rule again. So zero, 100, 50. Now it is pivoted at 50, so there will not be any consideration of the weight. The next is, at 10 centimeter, they have got a 40 GF ka force, a force of 40 GF over here. And so it's, the question is that having 40 GF at 10 centimeter mark and weight of 20 GF at 90 centimeter. So at 90, that is this particular point, is 20 GF over here. And now they are giving us questions based on this, whether is the meter rule in equilibrium. Now when it will be in equilibrium? Only when the clockwise is equal to anticlockwise. So we will just calculate this. So we will say first, sum of anticlockwise moment is equals to 40 into 50 minus 10 is equals to 40 into 40 is equals to 1600 newton. No, it is GF centimeter. Similarly, sum of clockwise moment will be equal to 20 into 90 minus 50 is equals to 20 into 40 is equals to 800 GF centimeter. So you can see that since both are not the same, that's why not in equilibrium, as not required. Okay, not in equilibrium, you can see directly over here. So first thing, they are not in equilibrium, and you can see over here the anticlockwise is greater, so the moment will be anticlockwise. How much will be that thing? It will be difference of two, about 800, but they have not asked you, so need not find it out. The next thing is that how can the rule be brought to equilibrium using the additional weight of 40 GF? So if I put an additional weight of 40 GF, so of course this side is less, so I need to put a 40 GF somewhere here. Now so the moment I put 40 GF over here, it will be this way, that the sum of anticlockwise will be nothing but 40 into 40 is equals to, over here will be 20 into 40 plus 40 into, this is x over here, so we can take it as x minus 50. So this is 1600 is equals to 800 plus 40x minus 2000. Okay. Sorry. And next will be 1600 minus 800 is equals to 40x minus 2000. So 800 or 2000 comes here, so 2800 is equals to 40x. So x will be equal to 2800 upon 40 is equals to 70. Is equals to 70 centimeter. It will be 70 centimeter mark. So you're going to have this at 70 centimeter mark. So you can just write over there that the 40 GF weight has to be, additional weight of 40 GF has to be placed at 70 centimeter mark on that particular scale. Okay, so this is the 11th question. We are left out with 12 to 18th, which I will send it to you later. Okay.